This is the video of our summative kalvi, grade 10, geography, new book, unit 5, India, population, transport, communication, trade, part 1. We are going to discuss in this first video, population and transport. Let us discuss about population. The total number of people residing in a country at a specified period of time is called the population of a country. India is the second most populous country in the world next to China. Census. Population census is the total process of collecting, compiling, analyzing economic and social data pertaining at a specific time of all persons in a country. Density of population. It is expressed as a number of persons per kilometer. According to 2011, the average density of population of India is 382 persons per square kilometer. Population growth and change. Population change refers to an increase or decrease of population of an area from one period to another period. Population growth is influenced by the birth rate, death rate, and migration. These three makes the changes in population. Let us discuss about migration. It is the movement of people across the region or territories. It can be internal within a country or international between the countries. Internal migration does not change the size of population of a country. Population dynamics. Human population dynamics is a field that tracks factors related to changes in the size of population and its characteristics. Occupational structure. The economically active part of a country's population is enumerated during the census operation as states as workers. Overpopulation. In India, growing pressure of population on resources base created many socio-economic, cultural, political, ecological and environment problems. Sex ratio. Sex ratio is defined as the number of females per 1000 male population. Age. The age composition of population refers to the number of people in different age groups in a country. Literacy rate. The people who are able to read and write are known as literate. It is an important indicator of quality of people. The percentage of literate people to the total population is termed as literacy rate. Let us discuss about urbanization. The process of society transformation from rural to urban is known as urbanization. See children, from rural to urban, people are going due to many reasons. Let us discuss what are the impact by the urbanization. Yes, it makes overcrowding in urban centers. Any other point? It leads to shortage of houses in urban area. Very good. Next, it leads to a formation of slums. Very good. Then, it creates water scarcity in cities. Good. Then, any other point? It creates drainage problem. Very good. Next, let us discuss about transportation. Transport is a system in which passengers and goods are carried from one place to another. In India, we are using road and railway, water and air. Let us discuss about road. Road plays an important role in carrying goods and passengers for short, medium and long distance. Roads are divided according to the places it used. National highways. These highways are running through the length and breadth of the country, connecting capital and states. State highways. The state highways are usually roads that link important cities. District. District roads provide connectivity between the district and taluk headquarters. Rural or village roads. It links to the different villages with their neighboring towns. Border roads. Border roads organization has constructed the world's highest road. This road runs at an average altitude of 4,270 meters. It is in Chandigarh and Leh in Ladakh. Then Golden Quadrilateral Roads. Golden Quadrilateral Roads, 5,846 km long road. India's four metropolitan cities, Delhi, Kolkata, Chennai, Mumbai, connected by these roads. Next, expressways. What is this called expressways? In Mumbai, Pune Road, Kolkata Dumdum Airport Road are called the express roads. International highways. These roads connect important highways of India with those of the neighboring countries such as Pakistan, Nepal, Bhutan, Bangladesh and Myanmar. Then let us discuss about railways. Indian railway system is the main of the country's inland transport. On the basis of the width of the track, the Indian railways fall under four categories: broad gauge, meter gauge, narrow gauge, light gauge. So these are the four category of rails. For operation and management, the Indian Railways is organized into 17 zones. There are 8 cities with this metro railway, that is Chennai, Bangalore, Mumbai, etc. Let us see about water transport. Waterways are divided into inland waterways and ocean waterways. Inland has an extensive network of inland waterways in the form of rivers, canals, lakes and backwaters. Ocean routes play an important role in the transport of sectors in the economy of India. Let us discuss about airport. Air transport. Airways are the quickest, costliest, most modern and comfortable means of transport. Domestic airways fly within the boundaries of a country and international airways connect the major cities of the world. Thanks for watching. Let us discuss next part, communication and trade.